We just wanted to know what Earth Day means to you and how you celebrate it.
I think celebrate is the ticket here. Earth Day to me is a celebration of the Earth and how we can protect it, and kind of a day where we can talk about things we're doing to better protect the environment. Mm-hmm.
So what have you done in the past that's like for Earth Day, like specific projects or activities?
Me individually?
Or like anything that you've done like from...
Or throughout the year, yeah. Like you were doing the annual reports, yeah. And that sort of thing?
Yeah, we do a lot throughout the year. And you might have seen the signs around Pomona that today is Earth Day. Yeah, so we're trying to emphasize that even while we're using Earth Day to kind of say, hey, let's celebrate and talk about all the things that all these student groups are doing, that there's still tons going on every day on the Claremont College. So, yeah, so the Sustainability Integration Office, we do a checkout program for students for drying racks and compost buckets. We check out to students too. We also hand out LEDs to students to use on their desks, and shower timers, 5-minute shower timers. You're welcome to take any of this.
Awesome.
But yeah, any day of the year, you can come by the SIO and get them.
Great. So, yeah. Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So how did you get involved with this sustainable farming?
I'm the farm manager now at Pomona. So I was involved with the farm when I was a student. At first I worked at the farm, and then I started doing farm club all 4 years, and then I graduated and became farm manager after that.
Cool.
So how do you think this is like an important part of Earth Day, or like how do you feel like this?
Well, a huge part of reconnecting with the earth is changing the way we eat and our relationship to food, because that's like the most, the biggest part of our day in which we're constantly like going back to the earth. Like we're like physically sustained by plants, and that connection has totally been lost. So like rebuilding that connection and being able to like know where your food comes from is like a huge part of sustainability and of like fighting climate change.
So, what do you think about like how like we used to farm like without all these chemicals?
And like, how do you think farming has changed since then? And how do you think, I guess, agriculture like, has affected different communities?
Like, do you think we have to like we should like go back to how things used to be with like smaller farmers?
I mean, I think that small organic farms are the only like plausible, sustainable way of like feeding everyone and not consuming more resources than we can replenish.
Hi. $7 for the sweatshirts and $5.
So I think we're eventually gonna come back to that, and a lot of like the work that we're doing, which is like education work, is trying to like give people the skills to be able to like go out and do this kind of stuff on their own, which is like ultimately totally empowering for whatever community that you're in, and allows people to not only like reconnect with the earth but also eat healthy food and like not have to buy it and feed themselves in like
definitely.
A more just way and more healthy way for their communities.
So generally like organic foods are like more expensive than the ones with like pesticides and all that. So how do you think that like widens the gap between the people who can afford organic food versus like people who are poor and they may not have the
access
option.
To land to
they,
grow it and stuff like that?
They may not have the option to.
I mean, the thing about urban farms and small organic farms is they're a lot more close to where people live and a lot more accessible to a lot of different kinds of communities. I mean, there's a huge problem with the food system, and like there's that disparity where like there are food deserts where the option is like Taco Bell or like Chipotle or whatever. And organic food is more expensive just because it costs more to produce. But I think once fossil fuels start to be depleted and we lose that energy source, it's going to become even more, it's going to become more costly to grow like conventional foods because we're not going to have that cheap energy anymore. And organic is usually grown without like as much input from fossil fuels in terms of fertilizers, in terms of pesticides. Those are all chemicals that are synthesized with oil. So I think eventually we're going to move towards organic, if not like becoming cheaper or comparable to like taking over the market, because people are just like not going to have be able to like keep perpetuating the system where we're taking all this energy to produce something that's not healthy and that's not nutritious.
Yeah. Anything else? Yeah. Awesome. Thank you.
Just your own group. We're representing EcoReps, which works with the Sustainability Integration Office at Pomona. So, kind of are kind of through the administration and. What we do is we kind of do a lot of different things.
Yeah.
We plan events, a lot of events, but...
Yeah, we're basically in charge of, like, incorporating more environmental aspects onto campus, particularly with students, like, making the SIO more accessible to students, and, like, green events, and just, like, ways that students on campus can get more involved.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So how did you get involved with this?
So it's actually like a job, it's a paid position, and then you're a resident, so you're like an eco-rep for a specific dorm, and you're in charge of making sure that people there have like compost buckets or drying racks if they want them, and then also planning events aside from that. So yeah, it's like you applied last year.
Yeah, and I got into it because one of my sponsors or mentors in the dorm was someone who was a... an eco-rep last year, so, and actually, both of our sponsors,
but,
got me interested in the position, and, yeah, I just wanted to kind of get more involved with the sustainability and, like, environmental things on campus, and
it's
definitely been a good way to start.
Cool.
Yeah.
So what do you guys think Earth Day is, and how does your program integrate with this?
Take your time, no pressure.
Yeah, no pressure. Yeah. Sorry, that was a big question.
I'm from Santa Barbara, so Earth Day is huge where I'm from, because of an oil spill. Like,
yeah.
They kind of want to, like, claim that they, like, started Earth Day, but I think that comes from a lot of different communities also. So it's been really big where I'm coming from, just getting people involved in a community setting to appreciate, like, more green ways of living. And so I think EcoReps is really trying to do that, to like encourage students just to live in more green aspects. So kind of having like a day to dedicate to looking at that is important.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Yeah. I'd say it's definitely just, to me it feels like a time to just kind of come together and like kind of look at the positive aspects of what we do with the environment and like positive ways to approach it and just kind of that community aspect and coming together and trying to appreciate the world like in a more sustainable way.
Yeah.
And you know, a lot of the personal changes we try and get might not do much.
Yeah.
Compared to like trying to change policy or trying to change those big things, but it's just trying to help promote a different mindset for how we approach things as a community.
Yeah. So on camera, can you guys explain the significance of this pool of water over here?
So I've done a little bit of work looking into this, but basically we were interested in the way food uses water, and most of the water use anybody actually has is what they eat through food, but it's kind of invisible, and so it's like 3/4 of water use. It's like something like 3,000 liters or something like that, but basically the biggest contributor to that, especially in the U.S., is meat, and even more so beef. And so there's a lot of estimates on how much a 1/4 pound of beef takes to produce in water. And that ranges, and that's taking into account like the water used to feed the cattle and like to clean the facilities and it's also, the biggest part is to grow all the crops that the cows eat, because the cows are actually, like, there's already a lot of loss of energy feeding another animal, but cows are really, really inefficient at it. And so you need to give them a lot of feed. And so a quarter pound of beef can take anywhere from, I've seen estimates of 500 gallons to like 1,300 gallons. And so yeah, the pool was basically, we were able to get a hold of, we were just trying to think of a way to show that. And so we got a hold of this pool, kind of calculated how much water was in there, and then put out a piece of meat accordingly. And it's, you can see it's not very much meat.
No.
Not much water.
And so we're kind of using that visual to like, for people to see the effect that it has, and then have that encourage them to like actually make a change in their habits. So just for a week, just like getting them to either eat no red meat or just no meat at all, and then hopefully that will be a little bit of a challenge for them, and then that kind of makes them reflect on like, why am I doing this? Oh, it's for this larger thing. And then throughout the week, we send out emails about kind of the implications of water use, especially in California with the drought, to kind of put it all in perspective.
Yeah, so like what the social impacts are and like where the biggest uses of water actually are. And like the there is the executive order, and it's against like domestic or like personal kind of use, which is like 14% of total water use in California versus agriculture at 80%.
Yeah.
So just like seeing, trying to like bring awareness to the effects of the drought and like where the problems actually are.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, you guys. No worries, it's totally
casual.
Okay, so how do you guys get involved with this program, and how do you think it's changed your view of like Earth Day and environmentalism?
Well, I personally just got involved because a lot of my friends were involved in it, and I thought that it was really interesting and cool and something I never really heard of. So I started going to meetings and just started to get really involved. I think it's a really cool campaign that we're running, and
I got involved in like the same way. It definitely made me look at like Earth Day and like sustainability on like a more political level. This is kind of like a political campaign. So that's kind of been like what differentiates our club from like other environmental clubs on campus.
Well, I got involved because I did a similar thing in high school, and so I heard about it and like thought I'd do it again. And yeah, I agree. I think it's like, makes me think of Earth Day on more like large scale, like just being like recycled or things like that.
Yeah. Could you guys explain like on camera like how you think politically this ties in?
I'm not the one.
Or like how divesting in fossil fuels will help our environment, I guess. How it's like pushing us towards the same.
So basically we're trying to get like a lot of institutions in the U.S. to divest from fossil fuels in order to like stigmatize fossil fuel industry in the U.S. because it's a huge part of our like energy source that's very unsustainable and bad for the environment. So basically we're looking at it as a way to like stigmatize that industry, stop the government from like giving them subsidies and different things like that, and switch to more renewable energy.
So do you think that science is like, with like all the issues going on in the world, like climate change, do you think that science, like progressing science, is going to like push us in the right direction and like make the Earth more like a better living space for everyone,
or the opposite, or anything between?
I mean, that's really the only way we can do it. I really believe that climate change is the issue of our generation, and there's really nothing like larger than that. And yeah, I really think the only way we can go about it is like by going forward with science, and also like changing like socially, like making social change as well. I don't know. I mean, there are a lot of things that need to come together in order to actually make a difference.
Okay. Anything else? Great. Thank you.